and I think it's very helpful for you to learn English the way I have. Oh my god, this is hard. Hello, hello, hello. Welcome back to my channel. Today is a very special episode because I'm gonna speak all in English. I want to do this video in very thick Vietnamese accent because I want to encourage my friend, my family, my people around the world. If you immigrant, you about to go to another country to start your new life, just remember you are so proud enough to learn another language and live in another country. Don't worry, don't care about what the others think about you. And I also want to show my stories about how English has changed my life and important of English when I live in America. In this video, I'm not making fun of anybody. I just wanna show that if I can speak English like this and all of my American friends can understand me, then you can too. I can do it, you can do it. Also, I will have some tips for you to learn English. And also, this video tribute to my best friend because he loves the way I speak English with a very thick Vietnamese accent. This is for him as well because I miss him. I think don't be shy is the most important thing that we need to keep in mind. Because if you shy, you wouldn't learn the correct pronunciation or the correct word from the person who tried to teach you English. For example, I remember when I first moved to the US, my aunt tried to teach me English and I didn't really repeat after her, or I just talked really fast so she couldn't hear it. But I was wrong, and then she made me to repeat after her until I get it right. I was so worrying that she would laugh at me or she would make fun of me when I say the word wrong or say something wrong. But that's not what the point. The point is, if somebody tried to help you and correct your English, so be grateful, appreciate them because they take their time to help you and you will be improved after that. So after a few times, I just really naturally learned English from her. Because I know that she tried to help me. And when I hang out with my American friend or native speakers, I always try to tell them that make sure they correct my English if they hear something wrong. So you guys, if you watch this video and you know that I say something wrong, make sure you leave the comment on the box and let me know what you think. What should I do better? Here's another little tip that when I don't know the word, I always ask them to spell it for me. So if they spell the letters out, and then I will get in my mind, and it's easier for me to remember the word. The second one that I would encourage you all to watch a lot of American English TV shows, movie, or read a book, or listen to a lot of music. It would help you very naturally and organically. It just gonna get into your head somehow, some way, I don't know, but I've done it, and a lot of people encourage we all English as second language to do that. At first, I didn't think that was a good idea. I was just like, what's the point that if I just turn on the TV and I'm doing things that I need to do and the TV just talk itself? So what's the point? Later on, I actually found out that it's got into my mind. And I didn't know how, and then I thought that was Vietnamese because I can just understand it. Make sure you put the subtitle on because you can look at the word and you can listen and look at the word at the same time. Then you get familiar with it and then you know, you learn from it. But when you feel like you can understand without looking at the subtitle, so make sure you turn off the subtitle. Remember the last video I did, I tried to learn Spanish in Duolingo, so you can use the same app to learn English because it's super easy. It will start from the basic to the high level. It's the way you can learn it too. So I encourage you to download Duolingo app and start learning English from there. This tip would sound funny, but I think it's very helpful, and I find very helpful that I have a lot of American friends or native speaker friends, because when I want to learn more a better English, they will help me. But here's a funny story that not all Americans are good at English. Some of them, their English sucked because either they're not good at punctuation, grammar, and another benefit when you have American friend that they will help you with a lot of things in America because it's their country, that their culture, they can help you to understand and you learn from them. It's a good thing. I said it's a good thing because when I moved out from my grandma's house, I actually didn't speak much English back then. And you know, in America, there's a lot of people work and they're all in English. And if you don't understand it, then how are you gonna find out? Thankfully, I have some friends that could help me. For example, if you drive a car and you get a speeding ticket, or you get some sort into the accident, or you have to go to the court to solve the issues, if you really don't know any English, you would freak the F out. Or sometimes somebody would knock on your door and speak to you in English, or the government will send you some sort of paperwork and require you to submit it or do something, and then what? So my point is, adapting English is the first thing for you to adapt the culture here or anywhere you live that speak the language, not Vietnamese. So guys, learn English, learn as much as you can. During that time is a great time for you to do it. Okay, if I can do it, you can do it. Okay guys, that was hard. So this is me, this is my voice. So thank you for watching for until this point. I just want to say it again that I did not want to make fun of anybody. And if you think I'm making fun of you, I'm sorry, that's not. I'm actually making fun of myself when I first moved to the US, that I thought that I couldn't learn English and I couldn't get it better. But I think that if you try to put yourself out there, get out of your comfort zone, and just show that you how much you want to learn, and you learn it. I think speaking English with a Vietnamese accent or any kind of accent you have is not the point. The points here are you brave enough? You should be proud enough of yourself that you want to throw yourself out there, get out of your comfort zone, learn another language, live in a different country. Moreover, I think this video, I want to encourage you all to learn English as much as you can, especially this time, is we have a lot of time to improve ourselves. And if you think your English is not good enough, it's time. Why do I say English is so important to me? Because it has changed my life so much. I started working in a pho restaurant where I speak just little English. Then I move on to a Vietnamese restaurant and speak much more English. But it's not enough when I really interact with American people or native speakers. I feel like I don't live here. My English is not enough for me to actually interact with them on a daily basis. So thankfully that I work for a American restaurant that I can improve my English. I talk more to people, I learn more from people. It's just how I open myself and learn another thing, adapt another culture. So that's why I think that English is like the first thing that you and I should adapt when we live in America. Some of my American friends always, sometimes they just remind me of how brave and how proud I should be that I live in the US. They said that most of them cannot even speak another language or live in a different country. I have so much respect for older people, especially Vietnamese people who live in America, that they try their best to learn, even though their English is not really good, but at least they try. So you guys, young people, why don't you try? And don't be shy or don't be afraid of if you're gonna mess it up, just do it. Because you have the ability to learn and you want to learn. Don't worry or don't be afraid of how people are going to judge your English. And don't compare yourself to anyone. Just compare yourself to you and try to be a better version of yourself every day. Okay friends, thank you for watching. If you like this episode, don't forget to hit the like, or you haven't subscribed my channel, make sure you hit the subscribe button and leave any comments you have. And I'll hope to see you on the next episode. Bye bye.